what kind of people are Bulgarians? It's interesting when I see the reaction of other people when I talk. And in the beginning was, first, some people find it's very rude when they ask a question and Bulgarians answer with yes or no. And English people find this very rude because you have to say, yes, I do, yes, I can, yes, whatever, you know, or no, the same. So it's not a single word answer. But in Bulgarian, that's the answer. You say yes, no, da, ne. That's it, simple, da, ne. Do you like this? Yes, da, no, I don't like it. Well, you know, well, you get my point. In English, it's different. The other thing is like, people ask if they don't understand and like, what? And it's like, and then the reaction, oh yeah, I love that. You know, she's Bulgarian. She's she's doing that. Or, oh yeah, it's so common when you come here and you hear all the time, sorry, 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 instead of I beg your pardon, all the time. So you kind of mix, excuse me, sorry, why I'm getting so confused? I beg your pardon. If you hear this all the time, you get used to that and you start using it, which is not always correct, but I suppose that's the tricks of the language. You get tangled in. Yeah, and the words. I personally find myself when I write, I can use more words and I can restructure my sentences, but when I have to speak, I'll go like my brain will go for the easiest, you know, part and whatever, because it's just used to that. That's it. So other people may find us a little bit rude because we are very straightforward people. If we don't like something, we will not try to be polite. I mean, we'll say, I don't like it. In English, you can say that's not my cup of tea, you know, you can use that, but I've noticed most English people, like a cold now, when they really don't like something and they try to be polite, they'll say, oh, that's very interesting, which means they don't like it. But they say, that's very interesting. And then, you know, oh yeah, got it. If they like it, you know about that. I found it, well, that's my kind of observation when we say something, I'm nearly there. I'll use, in the beginning, I was saying I'm almost there. And then I was hearing English people say, they use almost, but they'll say, I'm nearly done, I'm nearly there. And I was thinking that's, you know, it's synonym, it's the same, but yeah, the language or the way I structure my sentences, and they will say, that's a very interesting way to say this. I wouldn't say it that way. So what kind of people are we? We are very straightforward people. We can get heated sometimes. We are emotional people. I think that's for everybody, kind of. And maybe people who are like down, you know, more south, southern, they tend to be that way. People who gossip a lot, but then I know people in other countries gossip a lot. English people gossip a lot as well. And the downside you can find is that they are very polite, but they can talk behind your back, which I don't like. Another thing, what kind of people we are, I personally don't like that Bulgarian men, I'm not sure, but what I remember, I'm sure it's the same, they swear a lot. I don't like that. Another thing, I said that people can be rude, probably you know that. People can be also can be jealous. Like, I'm trying to figure out, and you know, when I say that, I'm trying to compare like more people, but in general, I think Bulgarians have that issue with jealousy and comparison in a way. If you have something, I have to have more. If you are feeling good and you're doing good, then I'm jealous because I have to do better than you. You know, so that sort of thinking. I hope it's changed, but that's what I remember from time back. But at the same time, Bulgarians are really friendly. They are very good hosts. They want you to feel good. They will, like, what I remember, if they have a guest, something, it's like have pros and cons. So if they have a guest, they'll just have so many dishes and you have to try everything. And they'll try to overload your plate, which is sometimes frustrating if you don't feel like eating too much or trying from everything. And you're trying not to be rude, you know, and taste. I was laughing watching the film My Big Fat Greek Wedding. If you haven't watched it, please watch it. I know it's Greek, but I found so many things that relate to us as well. And I was honestly laughing a lot because it reminded me of my childhood and my grandmother. And that scene when she was, you know, everyone had to eat and she was chasing the guy and who was vegetarian. And she was asking, oh, you're a vegetarian. Okay, I'll make lamb for you. So it's the same. I just remember my grandmother who was chasing me with the spoon. So I had to eat like, yeah, more. Anyway, so we have the same, we share the same things. It's fun, honestly. It's fun, so many things with the salt and I don't want to say that. Right, so watch that film and you can find similarities. And if you live in Bulgaria, you can share from your experience what you've noticed and found strange, peculiar, you can't understand, you can't accept. You're trying to understand why it's that way. I found a video on YouTube. A woman was doing different things like what does it look to date Bulgarian man or Bulgarian woman, French man or French woman, you know, all these different nations, and trying to capture the common theme. So it was kind of interesting, but it's not only Bulgarians. I know many people are jealous, but you can find this, the jealousy and possession. They can be possessive quite a lot. And don't forget Sandra Bullock played, no, Nicole Kidman and Sandra Bullock in the, when they were witches. What was that film? And Nicole Kidman, she had the Bulgarian boyfriend, if you remember, that they had to kill him because he was so jealous and obsessed. Yeah, there you go. I recommend you two films to watch. And if you haven't watched, there is a Bulgarian film that was made. I'm not sure if the entire film was made here in London, but it was made here in London. And it's in English with subtitles, English subtitles, I think. And it's called Mission London. You have to find it and watch it. Mission London. I'm telling you, it's a comedy. Watch it and share down below what you think about that film. And we can talk more about Bulgarians, what kind of people they are. But also there is something you should know if you have a Bulgarian friend and it's your friend, that your friend will do everything for you. You can rely on that person. For sure, I'm telling you. Oh, one more thing. I kind of cannot accept, but some people can get really upset with that is, I'm not sure if it's still the same, but like people can come without calling you and without, you know, asking kind of if it's okay, if you have time to come, they just can come at any time. And if you are busy, it doesn't matter. And it can be really frustrating because you can't do anything. And I find that Western people, when they have to do something or go somewhere, they have these arrangements in advance, which I find nice. Still, if you have friends, you can text and ask, are you free? I just need to see somebody, or they still can do that. It's completely normal, but still you have to ask. Yeah, I think some people will be upset with me about that, maybe. So there you go. You have another video about Bulgarians. If you have questions and want to know more, you can ask, leave your questions, and I'll try to find the information on answer for you. But you have to keep in mind that probably most of the time these are generalization. Is that the word? So you can kind of have points, but you need to make your own opinion. So you have to go experience, see, feel, you know, all this stuff, and then say, oh yeah, this is kind of right for some people, for most of the people, not for everybody, or it's not right. People have changed. Things have changed. So yeah, but it's fun to make videos like that because we can share things, we can kind of gossip a little bit, and yeah, have fun. So if you like the video, please like it, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.